dropped your keys?
They were back there on the ground.
Yeah, just right over there.
I'm a klutz. I'm so sorry. Thank you so much.
Holly.
Charlie.
Charlie Mack? The photographer? No way. I follow you on Instagram and Tumblr.
Really?
I'm not a stalker, though.
No. I know a lot of stalkers. You don't look like one of them.
Your photos, they're amazing.
Thank you. It's really just a hobby. I'm an agent. So.
Listen, I hope you don't mind me saying this, but you look way better in person.
So my pictures suck?
No.
I'm joking. Thank you.
So hypothetically speaking, right? Say I might know somebody.
Okay.
Who might want to do a photo shoot with you.
You might know somebody that might want to do a photo. Well, this whole hypothetical situation, let's see. They would have to stop by my studio. And then going from there.
If it's really what you need in love, baby, this right is a one of one. But you can get this hit whenever you want. So here you are now, and it's all now, and it's all right now.
To be more high energy, just stay having fun with us.
Amazing.
Great shoot.
Hey, check this out. Hashtag throwback Thursday.
Oh, who would have thought this little boy would turn out to be a porn director?
Wait, you're a porn director?
No, I'm not a porn director. I just did it one time to pay for school.
Leave Rick alone.
What was that at?
That was in front of Charlie's grandmother's house, right?
Yeah, that was the day Charlie and Sherry moved into the neighborhood.
I can't believe that was 20 years ago.
What was 20 years ago?
You were 20 years ago. What up, man?
Charlie Mack in the house. What's good?
My dog. What up? Hey, guys, this is Fawn. Fawn, this is everyone.
Hey, you know what, Fawn? I'm gonna move like this, too.
Oh, Hi, Fawn.
Well, Charlie and Fawn, this is Dana. Charlie, Dana is my friend that I was telling you about, the one that I invited here tonight. So you can meet her? Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
So it's Fawn like a baby deer?
No, like Dawn, but with an F.
We are so glad you could join us. So glad.
For you.
Have we made a decision?
Perfect timing. Ken, let's get everybody around.
Okay.
And I'll take a Manhattan.
All right.
How's the wedding planning going?
Great new subject.
Okay, how's life at the agency?
Oh, we're kicking ass, man. Things are growing great, vivacious, killing it. I just signed Fawn here. She's a big Vine star.
So what? That's the thing?
Duh, it's like YouTube star. Mm.
Okay, well, now that everyone is here, I would like to ask a question.
Here we go.
And as I always say, you don't have to answer if you don't want to.
Well, before you ask your question, let me ask you a question. Did you ask Net News if we're gonna get paid for all these surveys?
Oh, you work for Net News?
Mm-hmm.
I have literally always wanted to be on there.
Oh, well, Ginger is a relationship columnist for them, so here's a chance.
Ginger, you got some questions to ask?
Okay, what is your deal breaker in a relationship?
Oh, that's simple. I couldn't be with anyone who doesn't want a family.
Well, I couldn't be with anyone who doesn't give head.
Baby, I'm talking about family, and you're talking about giving head.
Oh, I'm not talking about giving it, honey. I'm talking about getting it.
Okay, stop. Dana, what would you mean?
I would say my deal breaker would be... I don't know, I feel like relationships are so up and down that if two people really love each other and communicate, there would be no deal breaker.
Like that.
Right.
Yeah.
Chucks, your turn.
I don't do relationships, so I don't really have a deal breaker.
Oh, does Fawn know that?
Oh, I couldn't be with anyone who, like, doesn't work out.
No offense.
You're talking to me?
No offense.
I don't understand you. I don't get it. I don't get why you don't do relationships.
Come on, are we doing this now?
Maybe that's our cue. I think I'm gonna go to the ladies' room.
I'm just gonna go take some pics of her.
You take some pics. You send me some pics. Mm. You Snapchat me.
Why do you do it?
Do what?
Bring these little dinky girls around. I mean, you've been doing it since high school, okay? You're about to be 30 years old. It's time to grow up. Doesn't it get old?
Nope. It stays right around 20.
Whack.
It's not whack.
You know what? All I know is that you are not bringing one of these little floozies to my wedding.
You're right. I'll bring two floozies to your wedding. Hey, Victor, can I have a plus two?
If you don't...
That is not funny, Chucky.
Oh.
You know, I hate that name.
Gloves off now.
We gonna take it there?
You're lucky I didn't call you something worse. And if you keep it up, you're gonna end up with a plus zero.
Thank you.
What you even bring? I told you that I was gonna bring Dana.
I'm not trying to date Dana.
Why not?
Because she's your friend. And you guys know my rules.
Oh, you and fucking rules. Come on.
We gotta do the rules again?
Please.
All right, don't touch my camera, don't wear heels in my house, and don't be a friend of my friend, because I won't date you.
Don't make no damn sense.
It makes perfect sense. You guys know how I am with women. As soon as I have sex with them, it's like all of my interest magically disappears. And I don't know what to do after that. So, you know, if you hook her up with me, she's gonna end up hating you. It'll destroy your friendship, and I don't want that.
You know what? Actually, that is probably the most mature thing. You've said it a long time. You have a point.
Plus, I thought she'd be fugly.
Like the rest of your friends.
Oh, wait, man. The rest of
her friends are ugly.
You
couldn't
leave them. Erica was
beautiful.
Erica. Erica was beautiful.
Erica.
Erica was beautiful.
Hey, the
animal. What up, Charlie?
My man.
Usual, please, sir. Let me get a Greek goddess with cayenne and dark chocolate coming
on
up.
Wait, hold on, Nate. I'll have a sunny day with a shot of love, please.
Of course you will.
Thank you. Charlie, I'm starting to think that us meeting at this juice truck is your way of avoiding deep conversation with me. I kind of feel a bit hurt.
Hi, sister.
Hi, baby.
Okay.
You never call me anymore.
I texted you yesterday.
That's so impersonal. That doesn't count. The sound of the human voice, it does things to our soul, to our heart. Okay? By the way, I'm going to Mom and Dad's grave on Sunday, and I think you should come.
I'll try.
You need to start dealing with your issues, Charlie. I think that's why you have so many walls up. You know, your heart is frozen because of your emotional immaturity and your unwillingness to accept that you're deeply scared of love. Charlie!
Hey, you!
Hi.
Tammy!
Tammy. Looking good. Fantastic.
Then why have you been avoiding me?
I'm not avoiding you.
I text you, I called you.
Tammy, let me stop you right there. It's Tammy, right? No, don't put the wall up. Come back, come back. Look at me. I'm guessing you've got daddy issues. That's why you seek approval in these shallow relationships.
Not that shallow.
That only leaves you feeling depressed. Do you go to sleep every night crying? Bottle of whiskey by your bedside, huh? Watching reruns of Friends? Feeling cheap and unwanted? I've been there. Hey, I help Miley Cyrus. I can help you too.
Who is she?
I'm his sister, and I'm a therapist. And baby, I think you need a hug and my card, okay?
Look, I do pro bono work. You might not be able to afford me because I've, you know, I'm at my prices recently, but
I'm gonna call you. You do that now. Okay.
I'm gonna call you.
Listen, I'll be the mom you never had. Your daddy loves you. Is she flirting with me right now?
You men always think you don't need therapy. It's hilarious. You know, I have this client, wrote a whole song about how he's not worried about anything. Turns out, that's all he talks about at therapy. How he's worried about this, worried about that. Got a girl, and maybe she doesn't think his penis is big enough. He's worried about that. And you know what? Comes in every single session with a monkey, clutching it like it's his baby blanket.
You speak French, Montana?
What?
Rapper, monkey,
no.
Ain't worried about nothing.
How did you get French Montana from that?
Because he has a monkey.
No, that is not who I'm talking about.
He has a
Seriously.
Big record call, ain't worried
no,
about
No, it's not French Montana. Do you know how many people have pet monkeys? A lot of people have it. Yeah.
Morning, John.
Nick.
Good to see you.
Hi.
Hi, Tiffany. Good morning, Kareem. Good
morning.
Is Dallas in my office?
No, Dallas is in Texas.
Really?
No, really. Actually, he is. He sent his protege, Timothy Delaghetto. He's inside waiting for you.
Got it. Roll my calls in 30 and my coffee.
It's already on your desk, sir. Black, two stevias next to the trays.
Yeah, and again, no sir, okay? Call me Charlie, Charlie Mac. Don't call me sir.
Yes, sir. I mean, Charlie. Charlie Mac. Stupid joke.
Timothy.
Hey, what's up, man? Yeah, man. I like that coat, man.
Thank you. Thank you so much, man. You are on fire right now.
I'm trying, man.
What is it, 3 million followers on YouTube?
Yep.
600 million views. What's the last email?
600 million views.
Love it. So what's next?
That's why I wanted to talk to you. I think I'm ready to start this new project.
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to be like the Asian Will Smith.
The Asian Will Smith?
Yeah, TV, movies, Grammys, all that.
I love it. I love the ambition, all right? We're gonna slow it down just a little bit. Now back to YouTube.
There's Net rag.
Abram, I'm here with a client.
Client? Who is he?
An important client.
Okay. It doesn't matter. I have real business to discuss.
Could you excuse me?
Sorry. Okay.
What's the very short version?
Marty's about to call us in the conference room for a meeting because I just signed this huge company. They have a shitty product, but it doesn't matter because they threw a shit ton of money at it. And of course, I told him I could recoup the money. I just need a brilliant plan from you, my man, to make sure that the agency doesn't get fucked in the ass for the next 20 years with losses. You know what I mean?
I hate when you do that.
Hate when I do what? Sign big companies?
Why are you still riding on that?
Why do you not have one of these? We're about to be in the Jetson season.
Mayor Edge, Charlie McIntyre's office.
Conference room in 5 minutes. Mm-hmm.
Okay. That was Marty's assistant. He wants to meet you in the conference room in 5.
All right. Give me everything you have on.
Mobilitech Industries.
Mobilitech Industries. Text it to my phone immediately. And tell Tim I'm sorry something came up, all right? We'll reschedule as soon as possible.
No, he won't, because this is more important.
It's great to meet you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Sit down.
Marty, who's?
Mobilitech. Ever hear of them?
No.
Neither has the rest of the world. They created an app that was obsolete before it even launched. And what does this app do, you ask?
Blocks unwanted callers.
So what's the problem with that?
Cell phones already have that feature on the phone.
You're goddamn right. And go to my iPhone right now, scroll down to my skank ex-wife's contact, and hit block this caller. Normally, I would tell these guys to drive their non-pussy-getting hybrid off to San Francisco Bay Bridge, but I can't because we're caught in their parent company. Oh, it also has a retina scan component for testing your emotional state or some sissy bullshit. Look, these guys lost me at hello. How do we give these sagging tits a facelift?
You lost weight. You look great, Marty.
Ah, thanks.
Back to this app. Me and Abram were just meeting about it. We have some great ideas. Just need a little time to flush it out.
Great. You got till Wednesday. Yeah, I need a happy ending by Wednesday. Good talk.
I got no idea what I'm gonna do. I gotta come up with something brilliant, man. I never even heard of Mobilitech. I didn't think you were gonna make it. I thought you had to work.
Nah, my freaking boss cut back on my hours.
Permanently?
I don't know, but it couldn't come at a worse time. Do you have any idea how much peonies cost?
What's a peony?
I don't know, but they sound expensive as shit. This wedding is killing me. And I had to deal with Ginger talking about you bringing Fawn to dinner all night.
My bad.
My bad. It wouldn't hurt if you would just try to get into a relationship, like the rest of us.
No.
What happened to Ginger's friend, Dana?
She was fine. Mm-hmm. But that's not the point. Listen, man, you know my rules.
Yes, I do know your rules. And all those right. Rules are stupid.
They're very smart rules.
They're ridiculous.
Strategic rules.
Especially the shoe thing. It doesn't make any sense.
If you take a girl's shoes off, you're one step closer to taking her pants off. Slide move.
That works?
Yeah. Plus, it's sanitary. They don't scuff up your floors. You gotta think, man.
Starting to make a little bit of sense.
Hey! There he goes.
Uh-oh. Come on.
Shut up and run.
Come on, Struggle Bear. You can do it.
You've been working out, man.
Fuck you. Are you thirsty? You want some water?
Water's for pussies.
Yo, you talking crazy about Fawn the other day. You couldn't go one round with her in this shit.
Please. Sex endurance and hike endurance are completely different shit. Presley and I have been having sex like 10 times a day trying to have this kid, and this is way easier than that.
Oh, what'd you just say?
Motherfucker, I know sex endurance isn't a word. Get off my motherfucking back.
Wait. No, I think Chucks is talking about you saying you and Presley are trying to have a kid.
I said that out loud?
Yeah, you said it out loud. Yeah. Are y'all trying to have a kid or not?
I was using my inside voice. Yes, we're trying to have a kid.
That's awesome, man. Congratulations. Oh, man. Why you ain't tell us, man?
Stop messing around. Stop messing around. She's not pregnant yet.
Ah! Wait up! I'm on my
roll up and fuck tonight. She on her. You put it. Okay, this is some 50 Shades shit. I can't. Look, I told you, I don't want all of this stuff at my bachelorette.
Where else are we gonna find little cups with penises? Besides, I'm not only here for you.
Oh, you and Rick use toys?
Not usually, but we need something to spice it up.
Mm. Trying to have this baby is a haze. And I never thought I would say this. I think I hate sex.
Oh, no. That's not good.
Ooh. Yeah, I'm gonna need this.
Oh, girl, you do not want to get that water-based lube.
Trust me, it'll dry up so fast, and your man will be going in, and you'll be like, oh, hell no. Okay, get the silicone base.
Oh, yes, definitely. Excuse me. Hi. You just seem very educated on the subject. Mm-hmm. My friend here, she's trying to spice up her sex life a little bit. Do you have, I don't know, anything that you would suggest?
Do I? How much time you got? Girl, you must be trying to have a baby. Me and my man went through the same thing. Mm. All right. This miniature whip is good for when he's slacking off with the stroke. You should give him a little pop.
Oh!
Ooh.
Ain't worried
about none. Nigga, ain't worried about none.
I don't understand how she does that.
I don't know why you don't want to see her again.
Guys, I've moved on. I think you should too, right?
I'm just trying to live vicariously through you.
Hey!
Hey, Charlie. The usual?
Yes, sir. Hey, y'all want anything?
I'm good, thank you.
Cool. And make sure to send me the schedule for the juice truck next week.
Absolutely, man. I'll do that.
Hot dog. Yes, sir. Hey, Carolyn.
Hi.
You, sir.
I gotta say, all these one-night stands, I think you're missing out, bro.
I'm with Vic on this one.
Guys, what the hell am I missing out on, all right? You jack off to pictures of the women I date.
Okay, first of all, that was one time. And you said you weren't gonna see her.
Holy shit. That's her.
Who?
Don't look. Don't look. All right, God. Stop looking. That's the Don piece I was telling you all about from work the other day.
Okay.
She left before I could holler. God damn, I'll tear that ass up.
Hey, it's not always about sex, Charlie.
Says Mr. Celibacy.
Hey, I bet if you were with a woman and gave it a shot, you'd get caught up.
That you could actually have a conversation.
No, I would not.
Yeah, you would.
I would.
Yeah, you would. How do you know? You never even tried.
Yo, because I know me, all right? Look, you've been dreaming about being with Ginger since we were kids.
Oh.
You've been dreaming about having little Rickies running around. I've been dreaming about making money, driving a fast car, and fucking models. We're not built the same.
I call bullshit.
Bullshit, homie. Sorry, you're just covering. You are trying to protect yourself from falling in love.
Yo, dude, I don't know what y'all are talking about.
All right, so take us on a bet.
Mm-hmm.
You date a woman till Vic's wedding and see if you get attached.
The same woman.
What does that mean? So I got to date one, I can smash other joints?
No. You don't get to date and smash. It's a package deal. Date one, smash one. One.
So I got to date one girl, hang with the same girl?
Yes, dating and hanging. That's kind of how it works.
Until his wedding.
My wedding.
Deal. I'll take you up. One woman until Victor's wedding. And when I do this, the two of y'all will agree to never bring this shit up again.
And when you don't do this, our reward will be finally seeing you happy.
Nah, I don't like that reward.
No?
My reward idea would be something like a 3D flat screen television. You know what? Let's keep it 100. How about this? When you lose this bet, I get to deliver the best man speech at his wedding.
Are you okay with this?
I am all kinds of okay with it.
Deal.
To the eyes. To the eyes.
I got
Make
you.
Make it real.
To the eyes.
There it is.
Rick Adams, cayenne, dark chocolate.
Idiots, man. Oh, I'm sorry. This is mine. That's a Greek goddess with cayenne and dark chocolate. That's my drink. Eva, I saw you earlier this week at Premier Edge.
Yeah, you did.
So
I'm a dime, huh?
Yes, you are.
And you would tear my ass up.
Oh, shit. You heard our conversation.
Yeah, you boys were kind of loud.
I'm sorry. Let me make it up to you.
It's OK. Don't worry about it.
No, no. Hold on. Hold on. Here's my card. Let me take you out.
No, but thank you. I know your type. You're the Lothario, right?
The Lothario?
Yeah, you think you know everything about women.
You can teach me what I don't know.
You couldn't handle me.
Green goddess with cayenne dark chocolate.
But good luck with your best.
Sorry about that. I probably deserve that.
Sorry about that, Charlie. I got this.
It's all good. So don't worry about it.
That was very valiant of you, Charlie. Your drink's ready.
Call me one time.
Hey, Kareem, I need that research on Mobilotech.
Sir,
send it to my... Yo, what are you... Hello?
Avesha is here. She wants me to purify the space before she comes in.
Karen, you know you're supposed to schedule with Kareem and not just show up. What? What are you...
I'm sorry. I'm using the purification app.
Seriously? What are you doing?
Avesha is driving me nuts. She's driven everyone away. Just about everybody has quit. The housekeeper's quit. The feng shui specialist has quit. You know her Italian greyhound ran away? Only it didn't run away. It went to a neighbor's house because it just wanted to get away from Avesha.
Okay, Karen, calm down, all right? I'll fix it. Send her in.
That's all, Boris.
Avesha? Seriously?
Oh, my spiritual advisor says that I should conserve my personal energy whenever I can. And it's good to keep your feet off the earth for at least an hour a day.
You know couches do that, right? Hold on, so all this on Twitter about you acting like a crazy diva's true.
You know what? I don't appreciate that, Charlie. But my advisor says that I can't engage in any negative facial expressions. So Karen does that for me now. Karen?
You gotta be kidding me. Y'all are serious. Boris, a purification act. Babe, this is all hurting your fan base. People want their stars to be relatable. Right now, your fans are unfollowing you as fast as they're creating memes about you.
Karen.
Look, Avesha, I believe in you. But this is a big opportunity. You're for a major part in a Marvel film. But the studio's not gonna hire you if they think you're gonna be trouble.
I am not trouble.
That...
Did you spray that in my hair?
No, no, no.
It's trouble. No, I know you, huh? You do this every time you get afraid. This is a new career for you, I get it.
Listen, the director and his team want to meet me.
Yeah, that's fine, I'll be right there with you.
They said alone.
I'll fix it, okay?
Okay.
You and me, we'll take this first step together, okay? All right, now I want you to get up. Boris, stop, just stop, all right? Stand down. We'll take this first step together, okay? Cut all that craziness out.
But my spiritual advisor
should concentrate on your spirit. I got your career.
Okay.
Mwah, mwah. Okay. Little pop star, you.
Okay. Bye.
Knock him dead.
All right now.
Oh my God, Charlie, you are like the diva whisperer. Thank you.
All in a day's work. You know, that's what I do.
I heard. You did, my friend Julie.
Julie.
Did you not call her?
Yeah.
I'm worried about your karma.
I thought I didn't text her.
This is my gift to you. Namaste.
I'm surprised you texted me.
I'll admit, I'm intrigued by your situation. You really think some people aren't meant to be in relationships?
I believe everyone's different.
So you've never been in a long-term relationship?
No. You?
I've never been in a short relationship.
So why are we here?
Well, I'm not sure that you're my type, Charlie, but I like that about you.
I'm not sure you're my type.
Really?
Yeah.
What's your type?
Fun,
No expectations.
So no strings, right?
No strings.
Well, you might be right. Maybe I'm not your type. But I want to try something new, something different. But I can't be in a relationship right now.
So what are you saying?
So I'm saying keep your phone handy.
I ain't worry about nothing. I ain't worry about nothing. I ain't worry about nothing. I ain't worried about nothing.
Kareem.
Brown bag with that work. Strapped up with that Nina. Got two bad bitches.
Kareem. I'm sorry. I was just talking to my ex on my phone, and I'm worried. I mean, I'm not worried, you know, because I got it all under control, and there's nothing to worry about.
No, so stop.
It was...
No need to apologize.
There's nothing to worry about. I'm sorry.
That's brilliant.
That shouldn't happen at all.
Get my sister on the phone.
Yes, calling from Charlie McIntyre's office.
Sir, Charlie, your sister's on the line?
Tell her I'll hit her from the car. Sure you were still coming.
Me either.
Water.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Hey.
Do you want still or sparkling? Holy shit. Busted my lip.
Sorry, I get pretty excited.
No need for an apology. Get you some water.
Thank you. Do you actually have wine?
Yeah. As a matter of fact, I do.
Is this the La Chapelle?
No. Actually, it's mine.
You have a great eye. What do you shoot with?
I used the Nikon D700 for that, but... You know what I really want is a vintage Leica. It's just hard to find. Those things like tanks. You into photography? Looks good on you, by the way.
Well, I'm into a lot of things.
Really?
Really.
Cheers.
That's good. What is this?
It's Carmenere. I call it the House of Cards wine because that's what they were drinking on the show. So good.
This is the same wine that Claire Underwood drinks on the show?
Don't do that. Don't try to act like you know about House of Cards to, like, connect with me. That's, like, don't try to do it.
Stop.
You're in the House of Cards.
Who isn't in the House of Cards?
That's my show. I love that show.
So this situation, then.
Mm-hmm.
It's just fun. No attachments, no strings, right?
Look at this face. All fun.
No attachments,
none of that. It's all fun?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Well, good. Because I need fun.
You too.
I do. I need fun.
Who does it?
Give me another one. Come in.
Hey, baby.
Close the door.
Baby? Okay, I know I have some strong swimmers, but I don't think they can swim that fast.
I'm not one of your hussies on your dating show, Rick. Okay? I'm a fucking lady. Close the door! Ugh.
Hey, I'm gonna go down and make some hot cocoa. You want some?
Of course I do.
All right, here's your hot cocoa. With all the accoutrements. Got some tiny marshmallows. Got the whipped cream. And a little bourbon to take the edge off.
Rick!
What?
You know I can't be drinking. If that test in there comes out positive, but baby's gonna come out with her eyes too close together.
Babe, I was playing. The bourbon's for me.
Oh, why are you playing? What if something's really wrong with us?
There's nothing wrong with us, honey. I promise.
We've been trying for 7 months.
Yeah, that sounds about right. You just got off of birth control.
Just because you love vagina doesn't mean you're a gynecologist.
I never said I was a gynecologist. I just think you're overreacting. And by overreacting, I mean we just need to give it more time.
Oh.
Yeah. Look, if the test is negative, we can always try again.
I don't want to have any more sex.
Huh?
This has become work, and I don't want to work. I want to be a stay-at-home mom.
I hear that.
If you hear that, put the whipped cream down. I want a baby.
Come here. Look, if the test is negative, I promise we'll go to the fertility specialist.
For real?
For real.
You promise?
I promise. You're crazy. You know that, right?
I know.
Yeah. I like that about you, though. Let's go see if we got a plus or minus. Come on. Come on.
French Montana.
Charlie, right?
Yeah, man.
You all right?
What up? Yeah. We met at Puff's house, the pool party.
What's up, that time. Now, I remember you had got them big endorsement deals, man. Big money, man.
Yo, nah, that's what I do, man. Try to make money for my clients, yo. It's so random running into you here, man. The universe must be bringing us together, because I got a deal on the table that will be a big check for you.
Man, if you're talking dumb kind of numbers you got here, man, sign me in now.
All right. Let's do this, man. Stop by the Premier Edge office. Let me sign you up.
Hold on. Before you sign me up, though, I gotta make sure your swag is right. Make sure, you know what I mean?
French, it's Charlie Mack you're talking to.
Rolling in the hand.
I got the hand.
Nah, you ain't got it.
Okay.
But I fuck with you, though.
Ah,
you know what I'm saying?
Nice.
Yeah, man. So, I mean, just change numbers.
Put my number in your phone.
Before I do any kind of deal, you know.
Okay. Yeah. Charlie, nice to meet you.
I gotta check in with Julius real quick.
Yeah, listen, I'm great with managers. Send them my contact info, tell them to call me. We'll work it out.
I like that suit, though, Playboy.
Thank you.
You look
you know,
a
I'm
sharp.
Getting it together, man.
You look
I'm trying
sharp,
to need
man.
A chain, maybe. Yeah, I gotta ask you, man. If there's only three of y'all, why does everybody drive their own car?
Space. You never know who you're gonna kidnap by the end of the night, my brother. Now, you make sure you use that contact.
Will do, man. Let's make this money.
Did you catch him?
Yes.
Well, I hope it was worth it. That was on the verge of being unethical.
I mean, in fact, I'm pretty sure I was completely unethical. You owe me big time, little brother.
I'm taking you to lunch.
A real lunch.
A real lunch.
A proper lunch.
A proper lunch.
No juice.
No juice.
That makes me so happy. That means we'll have time for a good long chat. There's so much that you and I need to discuss because you're at a pinnacle age right now.
No, not happening. We're not talking about my personal life, okay? But I do need to know about French's manager. Who's this dude, Julius?
Oh, Julius, yeah, he's the one that referred me to him. He's a monkey. But he's a very reasonable man. Monkey, but
all right,
listen, I would not underestimate Julius. He's important to that man's life.
I don't know if you're playing.
He's his guide. He's his spiritual teacher.
Would you please slow down? I don't even know how you walk so fast in those shoes.
Okay, this is the place in LA to get your wedding cake. They're like booked up 5 months in advance for a cake tasting appointment. We can't be late.
Yes, but online it says they give out boxes of free samples with no appointment necessary, so it's not even that big a deal.
Okay, you know what?
We cannot get our wedding cake from a sample rack. But it's so sweet that you took interest in it, baby. You like went online and did. Oh, okay, come on. Did you know that Oprah said if she ever got married, that she would get her cake from here? I mean, we're just like Oprah.
No, why would I know that?
Hello, we're here for the cake tasting.
Jesus Christ. Fuck me.
Baby?
Yeah, so listen, Oprah probably isn't getting married at this point, so we should probably take that as a sign and then get our cake from somewhere else.
No, we're gonna get our cake here with all your extras. Come on.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you, sweetie.
Here you go.
Yeah, delicious.
That's delicious.
It tastes really expensive.
Carrot cake. Is it 24 carats for $6,000 fucking dollars?
Well, take a seat, gentlemen. Marty will be right with you.
Thank you.
Can I get you anything, Charlie?
No, I'm good. Thank you. Stop. No, please, don't worry about me, Chesty. I'm fine, I wasn't thirsty anyways, you know? Thanks for asking.
Abram. Just try not to be offensive for the next 10 minutes.
Am I ever offensive? Fine.
Here's the deal. We're gonna walk in there. You're gonna let me do all the talking. You just nod your head, give an occasional, it's a no-brainer here and there, all right? Long story short, just don't fuck this up.
I'll be as smooth as Barry White after a bikini wax.
Okay, send the message.
He's ready for you.
Okay, gentlemen. Knock my fucking socks off.
It's a no-brainer.
We need new talent. Mm-hmm. We need to work for the talent we already have, and we need to find a way to make this app relevant. I have a way to...
We have a way to.
We have a way to do all three.
Explain.
I signed French Montana.
Who?
I ain't worried about nothing. Round with that Nina. Round with the AK. It's a song. I'm just gonna be...
Well, that's fan-fucking-tastic, Charlie. How'd you do it?
I promised them a multi-million dollar licensing deal with Mobilotech.
Elaborate.
First of all, this app doesn't suck. You see, most smartphones don't seamlessly block all of your unwanted calls or texts.
This app does. Huh. It also blocks them from your social media. But that's not the most revolutionary part. Sir.
It uses retina recognition technology to determine your emotional state of mind. So before you get to drunk dial, it saves you.
I mean, it's kind of just like the alcohol breathalyzer thing. You know, you breathe in it before you drive the car. I don't have one.
Secondly, another one of my clients is a big YouTube star, millions of followers. We're gonna get him to post an organic video about blocking an ex-girlfriend, but then missing her, getting a little too drunk and going to call her, and then getting saved by the app. Meanwhile, we'll have French Montana's I Ain't Worried About Nothing playing in the background because he won't have to.
And now that we own the licensing to it, that video is gonna be shared tens of millions of views.
Here's the bottom line. Our YouTube star is gonna get some big advertising dollars. French Montana gets a big licensing fee. Mobilotech's downloads through the roof. And the best part is, Marty, we get a piece of all the action.
It's a no-brainer.
Oh, Kareem, go on without me. Yeah, I'll see you downstairs. Hello.
Hey.
A phone call.
No, I know. Everyone texts.
I like phone calls. It's more personal. Not that we're personal.
Well, it just so happens that I have an opening in my schedule for lunch.
You know, that's such a coincidence.
I have an opening in my schedule for lunch as well.
Really?
Really.
Have you ever been to Red O on Melrose?
No, but I'm sure I could find it.
See you there 20 minutes?
19.
Just sent the text like 5 minutes ago.
Look, we had a date scheduled with our DVR. We were gonna watch 6 episodes of Power. What's going on?
Oh, I'm sorry. What was so important you had to tell us in person? Do I have all your attention? Mm-hmm.
We're here, yes.
Come on. Well, you guys are now looking at the senior editor of the Lifestyle section of Net News.
Nice!
I
did.
Nice!
Hold on. So what does this mean? Full creative control over the whole thing?
It is. And they doubled my salary. So.
Oh, now you're talking. Yeah. Oh,
now that's worth the toast.
All right. All right. Getting that paper, baby.
Thank you.
We are getting freedom.
I'll be right back.
This is about, huh?
Yeah, no,
it's
$2.
We're
not. Yeah. It's called interest.
Bro. Interest. Now you can pay me back that money.
Yes.
Yes. Yo, man. You seem a little bummed. That's good news.
It is. Yeah. Good news. Good news.
Amen.
Good news.
Yeah.
Okay, so I have a question for you guys. Uh-huh. Would you come to my wedding if it was in a park?
Fuck yeah. I'm not sure your fiance would, but I'd be there.
Clearly, we're talking about something else. What's up?
You know what? I don't even want to talk about it. New topic. You, Bet. What's the update?
Uh-huh.
Oh, you know what? This might cheer you up, man. Nah, seriously, I met a girl. This girl is special, man. When she walks in the room, it's like I hear Michael Jackson's Butterfly. You remember how you felt at the end of The Notebook?
Dude, I really?
It's like that every...
Really?
Yes, it's like, no, man. Come on, guys. What the fuck is wrong with y'all, man? Dog, you think I'm gonna fall for some... No, the sex is amazing. She's cool, but I'm good. Not everybody wants that.
You're a dickhead, man.
A shitty
Thank
human
you.
Being.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Well, what dickhead. More should we expect from the guy who put out a wanted ad for a fuck buddy in college, right?
I don't know what y'all are talking about, man. Yeah! We're getting old.
Yeah. We're getting very old.
Yeah. But you like 19-year-old girls,
so it doesn't matter.
You got some admire? Okay, mommy. You know what? How are you, man? Can I get a round of whatever their drink is sent over?
my card as well. Thank you.
What?
For after the wedding.
I'm serious.
Because after I win this bet, getting right back to where I started.
Why are we friends with him?
Because he's the best hoe we ever met in our life, man. That dude fucked everything.
Coffee's damn free.
What's up, champ?
Don't you think it's strange Marty's coming down here? I don't think I've ever seen him out of his office.
Maybe he's coming to give us a hand job and tell us we just made partner.
Good morning, gentlemen.
Morning, sir.
So, I was lying in bed last night thinking. I often do my best thinking after a nice rub and tug. And my thoughts reflected on, are we eking out the most profit we can from this deal?
French Montana deal?
No, the fucking Vanilla Ice deal. Yes, the French Montana deal. You're planning to put him out on tour, yeah?
Yeah, absolutely. I actually wanted to tell you guys, Drake's people just called. They want to go out on tour with him.
Wow. Did you tell him yet?
No, not yet.
Don't. Let's put him out on the Premier Edge tour we're planning to promote. He'll be our headliner, shining his light on our clients that we're aiming to promote.
That's brilliant, sir.
Thank you.
Sir. It doesn't make sense. Why would he do the Premier Edge tour when he'd make way more money if he went on tour with Drake?
Right, but Premier Edge will. He'll be the headliner, first time, the first guy through the door. And it's good for the ego. What, are you banging this guy?
No, sir.
Whose name are on your checks, Premier Edge or French Vanilla?
Premier Edge, and it's French Montana, sir.
Make it happen. Good talk.
Why are you arguing with Marty?
We just signed French, and the first thing we're gonna do is screw him?
Technically, it's the second thing. I mean, you just signed a huge multi-million-dollar licensing deal for him.
That's not the point. We still gotta tell him that Drake wants to go out on tour.
Believe it or not, I agree with you. It is fucked up, okay? But we work for Premier Edge, and that's how they do business.
Yeah, but that's not how I wanna do business. We can be better.
I think you're too close to this, man. Just give us some time to think about it, okay? I mean, besides, it's not like it was a suggestion. You feel me?
Out.
Okay.
Hey. How you doing?
Good.
You okay? You seem a little distracted.
Mom, fine. Why do you ask that?
Because you usually try to take my clothes off at the door. Do you want a drink?
Yeah.
Vodka?
Yeah.
And do you want a double?
Double, please.
Are those Tim Biscuit?
You got a good eye, you know that?
I love his stuff.
Me too.
So, you know, it's okay if you want to do this another time.
No. None of this is about you. It's work, you know? It got me stressed out like a motherfucker. You want me to do something that's just crazy?
So then don't do it.
Just like that.
No one's holding a gun to your head.
It's not that simple. You forgot to take your shoes off.
You know what you need to do?
How is this not porn?
It's on MTV?
I don't know.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for another episode of Dating in the Buff. That's a wrap!
Hey. What you think about all the ass you're not gonna get after you married, huh?
Yeah, a little bit. Thanks for calling us out, baby. Hey,
anytime. I figured butt-naked females on the beach is a great break from wedding errands.
Yeah, that definitely beats picking up centerpieces, for sure.
That cost $150 a piece.
Oh, Jesus.
Here I am in front of half-naked women. I'm talking about centerpieces. I think I left my balls in the trunk.
Why are you so stressed?
Because I cannot afford this wedding, y'all.
But Ginger just got a huge raise.
So my wife has to pay for her own wedding. That doesn't sit right with me.
Come on, man. It's not like you have a choice. Ginger is who we're talking about. She's gonna get the wedding she wants regardless.
Speaking of the devil, we should get going.
Plus, it's not like having a sugar mama's that bad. I mean, it's not like you're a bum.
I wouldn't mind having a sugar mama. I think I'd be a good stay-at-home dad.
Well, it's not like you could ever bring your children to work. Look at you.
I mean, it could be worse, right? I mean, you could be getting your balls man massaged tomorrow.
What?
What? I said that shit out loud?
Yes. Uh-huh.
All right, look, I promised Pressy I'd go with her to the fertility clinic after she cried at the thought of having sex with me again.
Ouch. I'm sure everything's gonna be all right, brother.
I hope so.
It's those Brazilian briefs you've been wearing.
Mm-hmm.
It cuts your circulation off. Your squirt game is probably poor.
There's nothing wrong with my squirt game, okay? And it's not the Brazilian briefs.
I knew it.
Have you seen the population in Brazil?
His squirt game is terrible.
Shut the fuck up.
Dude, I'm playing. Co-signed. I'm playing.
150 million! My sperm count's high, and Robert Downey Jr.'s net worth.
You must be very proud.
I am very proud. I got the Michael Phelps of sperm. They got little gold medals around their little sperm necks.
Yeah. Why are you rubbing this in my face?
What? No, baby, I'm not rubbing it in your face.
Oh, no.
No.
Do you realize that this means that there's something wrong with me?
No. I was talking to my boys because they were making fun of my Brazilian briefs. That's all.
I don't see your boys. You know what I see? I see this little insensitive asshole who's gonna figure out where he's sleeping tonight.
Babe.
You think this is a game?
I don't think this is a game. I think I just got 150 million score on my spunk.
Cállate.
Baby, well, how am I supposed to get home?
You know how you're gonna get home? With your super sperm. That's how you're gonna get home.
I said, I know that I want it, and I live like I love it. And I said, it changes. When I want some peace or truth, I'm constantly assailed. And I'm wanting love deferred. But I won't stay. No. You never said just what you wanted when you wanted. And I never talked to you when I was all about it.
Hey, what's that?
I didn't know I was being watched.
Thought we agreed on no strings.
No, you can't open it yet.
Why not?
Because it's a surprise for your birthday. Just wait on it.
You didn't have to do that.
I know. What?
Nothing. But I have an idea.
It's gonna have to wait. I'm not ready since the last round.
Mm-mm. I want to shoot you.
No.
Yes.
I don't think so.
Yes. There's this place I've been wanting to shoot. It's in Venice, and it's beautiful. It's gritty. You'd be perfect.
I don't want your thousands of Instagram followers looking at photos of me.
I won't shoot your face in a recognizable way. We'll make the whole thing mysterious.
One condition.
I'm listening.
Promise to get your photographs published. People should pay to see your work.
You really think that much of it?
Yeah, it's that good.
Okay. Now can we shoot?
Work tomorrow.
work. I completely managed to forget about work today. The whole day.
Your job doesn't seem to make you too happy.
I don't know. I mean, I'm great at it. I make a lot of money.
It keeps you humble.
Well played. Well played. I don't know. I guess lately it's just been a place to collect a paycheck, you know? Mm-hmm. And today when we were shooting, that was awesome. That was the most fun I've had in a long time. That made me happy.
Maybe it's time for a change.
Maybe. Come in.
I really have to go, Charlie. I'm sorry.
One last kiss?
Just one.
Okay, one more after that. One more. One more. Mm-hmm. One more.
Sorry. Press kicked me out for the night. Sorry, he's rude. I'm Rick. You must be Mystery Woman. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Yeah.
Rick was just leaving.
No, I really gotta go.
No, you really don't.
No, your friend here looks like he needs some boy time.
I could totally use some boy time.
You boys have fun.
It's a pleasure meeting you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Really?
You gave me a key.
That was like 2 years ago, so you could watch my iguana, which I haven't seen since.
You know, I kind of feel like he's in the house somewhere still, you know? She fine.
Wow.
Holy shit, dude. Yeah. My man. Come on. Oh, wow. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to stop the love train, but... Look, Press kicked me out. She told Ginger not to let me in, and so you were my last option.
You know there's such things as hotels?
But you got all this space.
All right, man, what'd you do?
I don't want to talk about it.
The Michael Phelps of sperm?
Yeah, I said it. I might have got a little too excited.
It's the last one.
Mm-hmm.
Last one.
Pressy's worried that something might be wrong with her. I told her she's overreacting, but I don't know, man.
End of the day, these things always have a way of working themselves out, you know?
Mm-hmm.
You guys are gonna be fine. Mm-hmm. You guys love each other, man.
Holy shit. Charlie Mack just said something positive about love. Oh! It's that badass chick, isn't it? She's got you good, huh?
Maybe it's the tequila talking, but maybe just a little bit.
A little bit, huh?
I might have to bring a plus one to Victor's wedding after.
See, that's not a little bit. That's a lot of it, motherfucker. I knew it. You don't lie to me. Lie to your girls, not me, man. I knew it. You just like me.
Before I say something I regret, this is over. This is done.
All right.
Clean this up.
Yeah.
Yo, you trying to sweat this alcohol out before the fit anymore?
I am not.
Yes, you are, bro. I'm waking you up, man.
Hey. I'm happy for you.
It's just a girl, Rick. It's just another girl.
But I am happy for you. Get it. Get it.
Yeah. Enjoy.
Yeah, see?
Uh-huh. Okay. Sir? Enjoy.
To the family.
No doubt. Three amigos forever, right?
Mm-hmm.
Mm. You know what? It's good to see you finally enjoying yourself, man. Hey, did I tell y'all I got super sperm? Because I do. Be up in here sipping expensive champagne, trying on clothes I can't pronounce. Shoot. So what if you got to sell your ass to pay for it? But we living a good life right now. We living a good life. This is good stuff.
Like, you might be right about selling ass judging from the price of this damn coat. Jesus. Hey, look, at the end of the day, as long as Ginger gets the best man, because that's what she deserves, right?
Thank you, Morris Chestnut. Are you going to hold up this mirror? All right?
Hey, look, it's my wedding,
okay? Are you done?
Come on, I look good as hell in this jacket. She might be getting the best man. Watch out now. Come on.
Hey, is there another mirror around here?
Of course. Right there.
Thank you.
Let us choose our own dresses.
I know, because
ladies.
It's so cute. That looks so sexy on you. Your fiance is a lucky woman.
Congratulations.
I am not getting married. I'm the best man.
Yes, you are.
You look amazing.
Thank you. Oh, my God. E, that is the dress. Please tell me you know that's the dress.
It's beautiful. It's oh, I can't even talk anymore. You just look so
sorry. I love it. See, this guy can't even keep his eyes off of you. Isn't she gorgeous?
Yeah. You look beautiful.
Thank you.
Yo, I heard there was fine-ass female. Oh, shh. Yo. Hi. I'm Rick.
Hello. Yo, I'm out, man.
Yo.
A little bit short on the sleeve, huh? Yeah, tight. Sir? Sir! The jacket!
Charles! Yo!
What's going on?
You gotta check this out.
Merde alors, ces Américains?
Love you, love you, love you. Girl, you got me hooked. I want you in the morning. Yeah. I want you in the evening. Yeah.
Right. You get a 5-star rating, buddy. 5-star rating, man. Gotta do this again sometime. Hey! I know you. I'm sorry I left so soon. I didn't get to congratulate you, bro.
Charlie, don't.
No, I'm serious. Congratulations. Congratulations. You make for a beautiful bride. He's a lucky, lucky guy. Does he know that you're still fucking other men?
Stop it, Charlie.
Stop what? Asking logical questions. I mean, clearly I should have asked a couple more from the start, right?
No strings, that's what we said. You knew what you were getting into.
No, you knew what I was getting into. It's so easy to say no strings when you're already attached to someone else.
I wasn't attached.
So I'm your rebound guy, is that what I am to you?
Men can bounce around from woman to woman, but if I do it, I'm a bad person. That's not fair.
What's not fair is the fact that I'm standing here looking like an so, in love with a girl that I can't have.
We have a connection. But what we did isn't love. It's fun.
This is love. Why not give us a chance?
Lust is easy, Charlie. Love is complicated.
It's not that complicated. I know how I feel when I look at you.
Getting married, Charlie, and that's not gonna change.
Why are you even here?
I wanted to check on you.
I don't need you to check on me. Uber got my back. I'm fine. Adios, Sifa.
Where the hell is he? Hey, Kareem.
Yes, sir.
We're waiting like 20 minutes. Does Charlie know the meeting time?
Yes, sir, he does. Let me check his work cell again.
You know what? Let me check.
Good idea.
Where are we?
Well, we're on time and growing impatient.
You guys could have started without me.
No, we actually couldn't.
Look, Charlie, I know you have some reservations about this deal. But we need you to get behind this. We need to lock in the tour dates. We need
Look, I'm on board.
What? Really?
Give me the paperwork. I'll let him sign it.
Good talk.
Congratulations. Mission accomplished. Okay?
I'ma lay down, and I'd be pleasantly surprised if y'all got the fuck out.
Hey, you need to chill, man. What is your problem?
Look, I had a long day at work, okay? I'm tired. I'm good. Thank you.
Look, we went through a lot of trouble for you, bro.
We're not 10 years old, bro. Look, why don't you go through this much trouble at work so you don't feel like a bitch because your girl make more money than you?
Wow.
You need to check yourself.
I need to check myself.
Yeah, you need to check yourself.
I need to check myself, Rick. Well, why don't you start by checking yourself, huh? Why don't you start with your girl? Why don't you tell her how you really feel? We all know that having a family is a deal breaker for you. You want to have kids. Your girl can't get pregnant.
Dude, let's talk about it.
Yeah, seriously.
Honey?
No. What the fuck is your problem?
What the fuck is...
You're just miserable.
What the fuck is my problem, Press? My fucking problem is everybody acts like their life is so perfect. Everybody's fucking perfect. But me. But Charlie. Kareem, get the hell out of here. Get the fuck out. Why are you even here?
Yo, are you serious right now?
Am I serious? Am I serious? Guys, listen, man. We don't have to do this, man. Why don't you take your ass, go home, and let me be alone, okay?
Why you gotta be such an asshole, man?
No, he's not being an asshole. He just wants to be alone. You know what? It's so crazy because you do that so well, Charlie.
What's that?
Be alone. Let us know how that works out for you.
Thank you, Ginger.
You need to grow up.
Okay.
Sad.
Victor, you got shoes on in my crib, man. You got shoes on in my fuck out. You guys know my rules. I got rules.
I'd find you here. What the hell happened last night?
You know what happened last night. I'm sure they told you so you can go back and tell them I'm fine, all right?
Yeah, you don't seem fine.
I'm fine.
I'm not letting you off that easy.
What, is this therapy?
I'm here because I love you. Talk to me. What happened?
I called some people out in this shit. That's what happened.
What? Why? Why should you be calling anyone out on their shit unless you're willing to look at yourself? Sounds to me like you were lashing out. Come on, you had your heart broken. It's okay. You're gonna go through some pain.
She used me. She fucking used me, Sherry. I'm never doing that again.
How many women have you used?
Don't do that.
Karma's a bitch, isn't it? Look, I'm gonna keep it real with you. You set yourself up for this.
Did you learn this on your first or your second marriage, Sherry? Or any of your failed relationships, huh? You're such a great therapist, but how come you can't figure it out?
I learned this when our mom and dad died.
Fuck. What do they have to do with this?
Everything. Yes. You don't think mom and dad's death has anything to do with the fact that you're afraid of losing your friends to their relationships? That you're scared of committing to one of your own? You've never dealt with mom and dad's death. You will never go with me to visit their grave. Why? You're gonna really push me away. I guess you're gonna have to figure this one out on your own.
I guess so.
Well, I'll be sending you love and light. From afar. Very far.
To French Montana and this deal. Ah, yes. I am pigs and shit excited about having you being a part of the PEA family, a new member. Yeah. And I would be remiss if I didn't thank the agent that brokered this deal, my personal pit bull, Charlie motherfucking Mack.
Yeah.
Not only do you have the vision to make it in our business, you have the cojones to last. French? You ain't gotta worry about nothing.
Let's celebrate. Julius, let's celebrate.
French, don't sign that, man.
What? Why not?
What a kidder.
It's not the right deal for you.
Charlie, shut up. Hey, You want to be a big star, right?
Of course.
Then don't listen to him and sign the deal.
Man, what the fuck is going on, man? You've been kissing his ass all day. All this sappy shit about how he the man, praising him. Now all of a sudden telling me don't sign a contract. What the fuck is going on, man?
No, I wasn't kissing his ass. I was blowing smoke. There's a difference.
What you think about this shit, Julius?
Look, French, even Julius can tell this is not right. Look, you won't make nearly as much money on this tour as you would on the one we didn't tell you about. Drake's people called. They wanted to go out on the road with you.
What?
I should have told you, man.
Charlie, what are you, willing, yo? Let's keep it 100%. I mean, this is youth and an experience talking here. He's all about the money right now. I'm talking about a legacy. You can't put a price tag on the exposure that you'll get headlining your own tour.
Marty, shut up. Stop it. Stop lying. French, the only reason we're trying to push you into this deal is because it benefits Premier Edge. Don't sign.
That's it. You know, shut up. Security! You're fired.
That was the whole point. Good luck, French. Good talk.
I'll live in his house for the rest of my goddamn life if I have to, but I am through with this marriage!
Retina scan required to dial this number. Scan failed. Unable to dial, post, or text.
Look at this.
Why is it looking out like that?
Side boob on fleek.
Stupid! Charlie, look at this. Oh my god. He's so lame right now.
What's up with him lately? Huh?
Wow. That is such a waste. Wow. I'm in a maze and I'm in. I see my fears along this wall. I'm going insane. And I can't escape.
Because I want you and I need you right now. Oh, but it's too late. I guess I'm too, I know I'm too late.
So what's going on, Charlie, huh?
I wanted to apologize. You know, I was a real jerk on my birthday and after.
I understand. But yeah, you were.
Okay, you're really not gonna make this easy for me, are you?
It's not supposed to be easy, especially within these four walls.
All right, well, I'm sorry. Okay.
Wait, well, hold on a second. Sit down. What exactly are you sorry for?
I'm sorry that I hurt and pushed away everybody in my life that means something to me.
Keep it coming.
And I'm sorry that our parents died.
All right, let's dig in. Okay, let's go deeper with this.
What are we doing, therapy?
Well, no, I'm your sister. That would be illegal. But we're talking, and I'm a therapist. And let's not get off track. We've got some momentum going here. What are you grateful for?
What I'm grateful for?
Yes.
I'm grateful that I am finally learning to grow up. And I'm grateful I have some awesome friends. And I don't know if I've ever said it, but I'm grateful for you.
Charlie, I'm so proud of you. That'll be $300. No, seriously. I think you'll feel better if you pay for it. I've already had lunch.
Yeah, stop. Stop.
Come here.
I'm taking advantage of my vulnerability right now, all right?
Look, you were pretty young when Mom and Dad died. But they had a great marriage. I got to see that, but you really didn't. I think that's probably why I believe in love and why you don't.
You're good.
But I have to tell you something. Do you know what makes me happy? It makes me happy that you had your heart broken.
What? Why would you say that?
But it means you have the capacity to love. And that, my little brother, is a beautiful thing.
All right, now that we're good, I gotta patch things up with the crew. I don't even know if I'm still invited to the wedding.
Just because you were a jerk doesn't mean they don't still love you.
Okay, everybody! Everybody back to one! Come on, let's go, flower girl! Let's go, ring bearer! Bridesmaids, groomsmen, everybody, let's go! Back to your starting positions! We're gonna run this one more time!
Somebody tell this chick this isn't brain surgery. Walking down the aisle, left, right, left, right. Smile. I think we got it.
Hey, boy. Yeah, okay.
Hey, Preston. Any room for another best man?
Sorry, Rick.
So he's the best man now?
Okay, come on, people. Come on, let's go. Bridesmaid. That's a best man.
Don't look at me.
There you go, okay? And when they get halfway down the aisle, the rest of the wedding party begins. There you go. Okay, slowly. And smile. Okay, that's nice. Let's go.
Look, man, I'm sorry about everything.
Hey, you don't even gotta say it, man.
Okay, excuse me. You two can deal with your bromance issues on your own time, all right? This is a wedding, okay? I need you to focus, all right? Just focus, all right? Focus.
Yeah.
Who is that?
I don't know, but apparently she high as hell on cocaine.
Bride! No.
About time, little jerk.
Oh, I deserve that.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry.
All right, just come on.
Hensy.
I just want everybody to remember, a wedding is a magical moment that every bride should cherish as she goes through those long, hard, trying, seemingly insurmountable Mount Everest-like years that lie ahead. This is the day that will comfort her as she weathers the storms to come. Okay? Mm-hmm. So come on, people, just stop playing around and let's get it together. All right? Pastor, commence.
Straight. Hey. So, I still get the silent treatment from you?
I don't know, I haven't decided yet.
What can I do to speed this up, please?
Maybe you can start off with some pre-babysitting.
Yo, I told you, super sperm.
Congratulations.
It is about time, but didn't you just pee on that? Why is it on the table? That is just nasty.
You're not going to be able to fit into your dress. All calories count.
By the power vested in me in the state of California, as a servant of God, I now pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Victor and Ginger.
You always hear people talk about fairy tale weddings, but you never really hear people talk about fairy tale love. And that's what we're witnessing. That's what I've been witnessing for the past, what, 20 years? Yeah. Because where else other than a storybook would a 10-year-old boy with a dashing handsome looks meet a beautiful princess, fall in love, and never have eyes for anyone else?
I love you.
He never did. And yeah. I'm a bad influence. He never.
It's terrible.
A good friend told me that there's nothing more important in life than going after what you love. Or in this case, who you love. And while there might not be any perfect people, guys, there are people that are perfect for each other. And trust me, Ginger and Victor, you two are my best friends. You guys are my family. And I hope that tomorrow brings you more happiness and more joy than any of us could have ever imagined. I'm just happy that we were here to witness it. Guys, lift your glasses. To Victor and to Ginger, the perfect match.
I'm surprised.
I am, but
I feel like I could have taken some of these.
I highly doubt that. You see, it's a little different than shooting porn.
One time in college, man. One time in college.
Look at him. His parents would be so proud of all this.
Charlie, I love this. Where'd you shoot it?
I shot that one.
No, they are proud. I mean, we're proud. You know, it took him a lot to get
here. Real talk, this is impressive for a first gallery. Mm-hmm.
Coming to you soon.
Yo!
Yeah, dog. Yeah.
Oh, man, you got a dress shirt on.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for coming.
Hey, how's it going tonight?
You know, it's been a tough journey, but nights like tonight let me know I made the right choice.
Wow.
God is good.
Yes, he
all
is.
All the time.
Yo, look!
Dude, act like you've seen a celebrity before, man.
What?
Act like you've seen a celebrity before.
I'll be right back, guys. Thanks again.
French!
What's up, my bro?
What up, Eric?
Going on? Congratulations, man.
Ah, thank you. I had no idea you were coming.
Man, look, as soon as I heard about it, man, I had to come through, you know what I'm saying? Support my guy, man.
Thank you, man.
And I want to tell you, man, I appreciate you, man, for that whack-ass deal, Premier Ed. That was real honest to you, man, you know?
Yeah, I'm so sorry I got you caught up with them to begin with. How'd you hear about this?
My ass to the streets, man. Come on, man. Nah, my agent put me on.
Who you with now?
Actually, man, them dudes right there.
Abram and Kareem.
Man.
Welcome the whole team back.
Here, man. You know, I was hating how Marty was doing that Premier Edge, so I left shortly after you did on some Jerry Maguire type shit, right?
So I guess that made me Cuba Gooding Jr., you know what I'm saying?
Wait, is that Seventh Streeter? Oh, shit.
But we're doing real good, man. You know, a lot of good things happening. A lot of sponsorships, you know what I'm saying? Chico, bring the cash.
Okay. Oh, well, all right.
So like I was saying, you know, we always use somebody like you back home, man. You know, the agency definitely, you know, me and needs you back.
No more agency life for me.
And I'm at home right here.
Why? Still don't got it. But you know what? Bring me your most expensive one. The least I could do for you.
Consider it done.
Congrats, my brother. Really proud of you.
Love, G.
Remember one thing, man. Stay black.
I don't know what else I would do, but thank you.
I don't remember receiving payment for the use of my image.
See you.
You too. You look good.
So do you.
This is amazing, Charlie.
It's been quite the journey.
Can imagine.
You know, I never got to thank you for that camera.
Did you get a chance to use it?
Look around.
Wow.
So how's married life?
It's different. Challenging, wonderful.
Eva, why are you here?
Believe it or not, I heard about this from my husband. He's an art dealer, and he told me about this amazing exhibit. And it turns out it was yours.
That's crazy.
Yeah. You know, I'm really sorry for the way things ended with us.
Me so.
But I want to explain myself
you
because I feel like you deserve.
Eve, you don't have to explain.
Look. Our lives were completely opposite. I was with the same man, Kevin, since I was in high school. But when it was time to get married, he got cold feet, and I decided to test the waters with you. I'm glad I did what I did, and I don't regret it. I'm just really sorry that I hurt you.
You don't have to apologize. You know, for the first time since my parents died, I actually felt something. I actually allowed myself to feel something that never would have happened without you.
Goodbye, Charlie. Don't forget to send me that check.
Look, Keisha and Jackie will do hair and makeup. It'll be fine, all right? Yeah, Abram, just make sure Kim's on time. All right, I got you, man. Later.
Got an apple, beet, carrot, ginger, volcano, extra ginger.
Thank you, Nate.
You're welcome.
Oh, I'm sorry. I don't think that one is yours.
Apple, beet, carrot, ginger, volcano with extra ginger?
Charlie.
Oh, wait, Charlie?
Dana, your Ginger's friend.
Right. Good to see you. How's Ginger? Have you talked to her?
She's great. She's really happy. Did I miss you at the wedding?
Yeah, I was out of the country and I just got back 2 days ago. I was so bummed I missed it. But how was the wedding?
Oh, well, the best man speech was awesome. All right. Hey, are you with anyone?
No.
Yeah, that's me.
You wanna sit? Sure. Out of the country. Where'd you go?
Oh, I went to Dubai.
Dubai?
Yeah. Mm.
You still don't have any deal breakers, huh?
Me?
Yeah.
You still have all your rules?
I got rid of the rules a long time ago.
Cheers. Good to see you.
It's good to see you, too. It's funny, after dinner that time, I thought about you.
Did you?
Yeah, your smile. You got one of those light up the room type of smiles. That sounds so cool.
Even though our lives are crazy, I would
doing man shit, all right? Back up.
You gonna make me?
Oh, I'll make you.
How you gonna do that?
Manhandle you. That's how I'm gonna do it.
Guys, I'm standing right here. I am right here in front of you.
You wanna join?
Yeah, I like that. That's nice. That's nice right there. Yeah. Hey, let me ask you a question.
Yeah?
You got Hermes?
What?
I didn't say herpes. I said Hermes.
No, it's no, Hermes. 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 Yeah.
You owe me.
I got you. I will see you gentlemen later. I am off to get a stress release massage, if you know what I mean. She knows what I mean. Hey, hey.
You shouldn't text and walk, Charlie.
You have an obstacle course in your office, Sherry. What is this doing here?
This is a great object of design. In fact, it makes my clients feel very comfortable and relaxed because it feels like nothing ever ends. Circles are good. They'll be good for you.
I don't feel comfortable. I don't feel at all warm, fuzzy.
Isn't she gorgeous?